My name is Noel Gorelick, and I work for Google. I'm one of the founders of Google Earth Engine. Back in around 2008, we were working with some people who were trying to do deforestation mapping in Brazil. Very specifically, people looking for people trying to cut down trees that shouldn't be doing so. And the very first idea for Google Earth Engine was Google Trees. We would actually make a tree counting tool. But that was the basic impetus, was to be able to take data like the Landsat archive and count trees, map cities, and provide the ability for people to access that data and use it easily. And that quickly turned into something much larger. We're going to do more than count trees, right? If we're going to get all this data, we're going to do a lot more than that. And so over the course of literally a week, me and my partner, the first two people on the team, said, okay, we know we can do all kinds of land cover mapping with this. People use Earth Engine a lot for processing Landsat data, but the really nice thing about Earth Engine is that all the other data sets are there and you can merge them together. So it's actually somewhat uncommon for a user to just use Landsat because it's so easy to bring in MODIS and Sentinel and a bunch of other data sets. Most applications sooner or later turn into handling many different kinds of data sets along the way. Until this year, Landsat was by far the most used data set on the platform. Sentinel-2 is catching up very fast. The really nice thing is you can use them together. So almost all of our Sentinel-2 users are also Landsat users. Until that happened, being able to combine old calibrated Landsat 5 with newly calibrated Landsat 7, both geometrically and radiometrically, was questionable. People did it. They weren't always happy with the results. And now there's sort of a stamp of approval and a consistent calibration across the whole archive that make that vastly easier. So I think that's the best thing Landsat has done for their users since the data became free. I am excited about it working. I think it's definitely the next step for everybody that wants to be using Landsat data. One of the outcomes, I hope, is a per image land cover classification. So every single image will have a land cover classification attached to it. And that's really what users end up wanting. They just work with the raw data because that's what they have to do. But if you could just say, this is an urban pixel, I think 98%, 99% of all users would be happy with those results and not bother with the raw pixels. The exciting thing about where the Landsat program is going and the fact that Earth Engine gets to help is that the five most advanced scientists in the world doing remote sensing analysis can do some work, and then in a few weeks, months, maybe years, everybody else can do the same thing. And that's quite revolutionary for everybody else. The cutting edge of science moves on at the pace it has more or less always moved on, but the ability to bring the rest of the world along for the ride at a much more accelerated rate is the part we're excited about. So when the Landsat science team members, who are arguably probably the best in the world at doing this kind of analysis, make breakthroughs, we can transfer those breakthroughs to the Peruvian Minister of Forestry and Beekeeping in a matter of weeks or months. I'm excited that 8 years ago, the things that we thought were going to be the future are in fact the future. The future's now, and we're quite happy about it.